Perfect. Hey everyone, welcome back to my channel. If you're new here, my name is Alexander Demergis, and in today's video, I'm gonna teach you guys how to grow out your hair the proper way. I think these tips are gonna help you if you just started growing out your hair, you're thinking about growing out your hair, or your hair isn't that kind of in between to long stage. Now for the first tip, I know you guys are probably thinking this is cliche, but the first tip is the most important tip. Don't cut your hair. Just leave it. I know, trust me, you might get to that awkward stage and you're like, ah, I gotta cut it, it just looks so bad, let me just get a trim, maybe just a little bit. Trust me, I've grown out my hair for over a year now. I probably gotta cut two times maximum. People wanna get haircuts every 2 to 3 months. Don't even do that. Personally, I did it every 6 months. Okay, I think that's plenty, because otherwise you'll just be backtracking and just be taking you that much longer to grow out your hair, and that's the opposite of what you want. The whole idea of growing out your hair as a guy, especially if you're coming from short to medium length hair, is to grow it out as fast as possible and to get out of that awkward stage as fast as possible. We don't have the luxury of girls, how they always have long hair and they don't have to go through that stage, but we do. So please stay away from cutting your hair for as long as possible. Remember, gents, please keep in mind that the average hair grows at about 1/2 inch a month. So that's 1 inch every 2 months. So imagine if the hairstyle that you want is 6 inches in length. You know what that means? Let me do that math real quick. That means it would take you a total of 12 months. Yes, a whole year just to probably grow your hair out 6 inches. And I know when I say 1/2 inch a month, that doesn't sound like a lot. And you're probably thinking, all right, long hair isn't for me. I'm not waiting that long to grow out my hair. After a certain amount of time, you're not even gonna be thinking about your hair anymore. You're just gonna be living your life. And there's just gonna be less money going towards haircuts, and you're probably gonna be like, oh wow, my hair is longer now. And that's it, honestly. All right, for tip number two, I would say that you guys really want to stop washing your hair as often as you have been. I know that sounds gross, I know that sounds nasty. I'm not saying don't shower every single day. You have to shower every single day. If you don't, it's kind of nasty. But what I am recommending is that you guys condition every single day. Condition way more than you are actually shampooing your hair. So on the days that you are not shampooing your hair, I recommend still conditioning, still taking your showers. This way, if you're conditioning it, your hair won't be smelly, your hair will be a nice texture, and it'll feel just as clean, except you're not gonna be taking away all the essential oils that your hair actually needs to grow. I think washing your hair a maximum about 4 times a week is a good range to shoot for. I'm not saying 0 times, never wash your hair ever again. You're not allowed. But I think 7 days a week is a bit too much. So maybe try to knock it down to maybe 6, then 5, then maybe 4, I'd say. Say 4 is a good number to shoot for actually washing your hair with actual shampoo. Now, at least that's what I do personally. As you can see, my hair looks still pretty healthy. It doesn't look too greasy. This is my second day hair, and I'm planning on washing it probably tomorrow. However, I'm gonna be conditioning it in the meantime. And I think that's a great idea, and it's worked wonders for me. And for tip number three, I really recommend you guys stop trying to put your hair in buns if your hair is not long enough to put it in a loose bun. Because I know some people, as soon as their hair starts getting a certain length, they just really wanna take it, they just wanna pull it back, rip back, put all this product in and just pull it as tight as they can. But what they don't realize is that actually starts stressing all the follicles by your hairline, and it's actually damaging your hair, especially with certain elastic type hair bands. You'll start to see that your hair is gonna start breaking. Now, as your hair gets longer, as it falls out, that's completely normal, but hair breakage constantly from using hair ties and you constantly breaking it on your own because you're always trying to put in a bun when it's not long enough yet, that's where the problems come in. And next, for my final tip, tip number four, I really think to get past that awkward phase, you guys should be using hair accessories to make it more bearable during your hair growth process. Now, that awkward phase is when your hair is not short, it's not medium, and it's not really long. It's in that weird stage where you can't really do anything to really style it, and it always looks weird, it always looks odd. A hat is a great accessory for people in that awkward stage until it gets long enough to where they can start doing the things that they want with it. All right, so as you can see, wearing a hat really hides your hair when it's long, especially if it's in that awkward stage, right? And you can't really tell it's in the awkward stage if you have a hat on, because it just completely covers your hair. It completely covers those weird layers that are not too long. They're also not too short. And wearing a hat really helps as one of the accessories you should be wearing during your awkward stages. Up next, hair combs. Hair combs really work well. And I know people might think it's kind of girly, but listen, when you got long hair, you gotta do what you gotta do. So what a hair comb is that it's almost like a hair band, except these little teeth right here will help push your hair back just so the hair would stop getting in my face during that awkward stage when I couldn't tie it back. And as you can see, this is what the certain type of headband looks like with the teeth. It completely pulls your hair back out of the way, and it really helps avoid the awkward phases, but it's still letting your hair breathe, hang naturally, and not be pulled up into a hairband when it's simply not long enough yet. And lastly, the final accessory I guess you guys could use once your hair finally gets long enough is that if you want to find a way to style it, you can use one of these type of hairbands. Now this is a coil type hairband and it's like silicone. It's like this plastic rubbery kind of fabric and it doesn't leave any creases in your hair and it doesn't break your hair either as easily. And so with this kind of hairband in place, it doesn't break your hair as easily. So once you actually do decide to grow it out and it's at that long enough stage, I think getting one of these coiled hairbands is much healthier for your hair on your hair growth journey. I know that the journey seems long, that growing your hair out seems impossible, but just trust me that with these tips, it will definitely help make your hair growth journey a lot easier. So that is the video, guys. If you guys enjoyed these tips, if you guys want to learn more about grooming, hair, or anything else related to this topic, please let me know down in the comments below. Don't forget to subscribe, like, and share this video with your friends if you found it informative, and I'll catch you guys all in that next one.